गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, मीट नॉलेज हब में आप सबका स्वागत है। और लास्ट क्लास में हम लोगों ने सेमीकंडक्टर का थोड़ा सा इंट्रोडक्शन किया था। हम उसी सीरीज में आगे आज सेमीकंडक्टर का नेक्स्ट पार्ट मींस इंट्रो का नेक्स्ट पार्ट हम स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं। लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज टॉपिक विद टाइप्स ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर। वी नो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर, इंट्रिंसिक एंड एक्सट्रिंसिक। नाउ लेट डिस्कस इंट्रिंसिक सेमीकंडक्टर। सेमीकंडक्टर in an extremely pure form is known as an intrinsic semiconductor. When electric field is applied across an intrinsic semiconductor, the current conduction takes place by two processes, namely by free electron and holes. Concept of hole current we discussed in last lecture. Here we will also discuss about this. Suppose due to thermal energy, an electron leaves the valence bond to enter into the conduction band as shown. This leaves a vacancy at L, and now the valence electron at M comes to fill the hole at N. The result is that hole disappears at L and appears at M. Similarly, it is clear that valence electrons move along the path P and ML, whereas holes move in the opposite direction, therefore along the path L, M and P. This process means concept of hole current applied in intrinsic semiconductor. Now next part is extrinsic semiconductor. The extrinsic semiconductor has little current conduction capability at room temperature. So to be useful in electronic devices, the pure semiconductor must be altered so as to significantly increase its conducting properties. This is achieved by adding a small amount of suitable impurity to a semiconductor. It is then called impurity or extrinsic semiconductor. The process of adding impurities to a semiconductor is known as doping. Generally, one impurity atom is added for 10^8 atoms of semiconductor. And depending upon the types of impurity added, extrinsic semiconductor are classified into two types. First is N-type and second is P-type. Okay, next is first type of semiconductor, N-type. When a small amount of pentavalent impurity is added to a pure semiconductor, it is known as N-type semiconductor. The addition of pentavalent impurity provides a large number of free electrons in the semiconductor crystal. Typical example of pentavalent impurities are arsenic and antimony. Such impurities which produce N-type semiconductor are known as donor impurities. When a small amount of pentavalent impurities like arsenic added to germanium crystal, a large number of free electrons become available in the crystal. The reason is simple: arsenic is pentavalent and therefore its atom has 5 valence electrons, and arsenic atom fits in the germanium crystal in such a way that its 4 valence electrons form covalent bonds with 4 germanium atoms. The 5th valence electron of arsenic atom finds no place in covalent bonds and is thus free as shown. The addition of pentavalent impurity has produced a number of conduction band electrons, therefore free electrons. The 4 valence electrons of pentavalent atom from covalent bonds with 4 neighboring germanium atoms, the 5th left over valence electron of the pentavalent atom cannot be accommodated in the valence bond and travels to the conduction band. The following points may be noted carefully. That first is, many new free electrons are produced by the addition of pentavalent impurity. Next is, thermal energy of room temperature still generates a few whole electron pairs. However, the number of free electrons provided by the pentavalent impurity far exceeds the number of holes, so it is called N-type. Now let's discuss conductivity in N-types of semiconductor. When potential difference is applied across the N-type semiconductor, the free electrons in the crystal will be directed towards the positive terminal, constituting electric current. As the current flows through the crystal is by free electrons, which are carriers of negative charge, therefore this type of conductivity is called negative or N-type conductivity. It may be noted that conduction is just as in ordinary metal like copper. Okay, next is P-type semiconductor. When a small amount of trivalent impurity is added to a pure semiconductor, it is called P-type semiconductor. The addition of trivalent impurity provides a large number of holes. So P-type semiconductor are known as acceptor, because the holes created can accept the electrons. For example, gallium is trivalent, therefore its atom has three valence electrons. Each atom of gallium fits into the germanium crystal, but now only three covalent bonds can be formed. In the fourth covalent bond, only germanium atom contributes the valence electron, while gallium has no valence electron to contribute. In other words, fourth band is incomplete, being short of one electron. This missing electron is called a hole. Sorry, number of holes are highly more than electrons, so it is called p-type. Next is p-type conductivity. When potential difference is applied to the p-type semiconductor, the holes are shifted from one covalent bond to another. As the holes are positively charged, therefore they are directed towards the negative terminal, constituting what is known as hole current. And a point must be noted here that n-type as well as p-type semiconductors both are electrically neutral. Okay, now next is p-n junction. What is p-n junction? When a p-type semiconductor is suitably joined to n-type semiconductor, the contact surface is called p-n junction. It is the control element for semiconductor devices. Next is formation of p-n junction. One common method of making p-n junction is called aligning. And then properties of p-n junction. At the instant of p-n junction formation, the free electrons near the junction in n region begin to diffuse across the junction into the p region, where they combine with holes near the junction. This creates a layer of positive charges, means pentavalent ions, near the junction. As the electrons move across the junction, the p region loses holes as the electrons and holes combine. The result is that there is a layer of negative charges, trivalent ions, near the junction. These two layers of positive and negative charges form the depletion region. The width of the depletion layer is very thin compared to the n region and p region. And once p-n junction is formed and depletion layer created, the diffusion of free electrons stops. In other words, the depletion region acts as a barrier to the further movement of free electrons across the junction. The positive and negative charges set up an electric field. There exists a potential difference across the depletion layer and is called barrier potential. The barrier potential of a p-n junction depends upon several factors, including the types of semiconductor material and the amount of doping and temperature. And now, next and important part is biasing of a p-n junction or applying DC voltage across p-n junction. The term bias refers to the use of DC voltage to establish certain operating condition for an electronic device. There are following two bias conditions. First is forward biasing and second is reverse biasing. So, let's discuss forward biasing. When external DC voltage applied to the junction is in such a direction that it cancels the potential barrier, thus permitting current flows, it is called forward biasing. To apply forward bias, connect positive terminal to the battery to P-type and negative terminal to the battery to N-type. The applied forward potential establishes an electric field which acts against the field due to potential barrier. Therefore, the resultant field is weakened and the barrier height is reduced at the junction. As potential barrier voltage is very small, therefore a small forward voltage is sufficient to completely eliminate the barriers. Once the potential barrier is eliminated by the forward voltage, junction resistance become almost zero and a low resistance path is established for the entire circuit. Therefore, current flows in the circuit. This is called forward current. So, the following points may be noted here. First is the potential barrier is reduced and at some forward voltage it is eliminated altogether. Second is the junction offers low resistance to flow. Third is the magnitude of current depends upon the applied forward voltage. Now next type of biasing is reverse biasing. When the external DC voltage applied to the junction is in such a direction that potential barriers is increased, it is called reverse biasing. And it is clear that applied reverse voltage establishes an electric field which acts in the same direction as the field due to potential barrier. Therefore, the resultant field at the potential barrier prevents the flow of charge carriers across the junction. The main points are, first is the potential barrier is increased, and second is the junction offers very high resistance to current flow. Third is no current flows in the circuit due to the establishment of high resistance. Okay, next is volt ampere characteristics of PN junction, means VI characteristics. When the circuit is applied, the characteristics can be studied under three heads, namely zero external voltage, forward bias and reverse bias. First is zero external voltage. When the external voltage is zero, therefore circuit is open and the potential barrier at the junction does not permit current flow. Therefore, the circuit current is zero. Second is forward bias. With forward bias to the PN junction, the potential barrier is reduced at some forward voltage in the circuit. From now onwards, the current increases with the increase in forward voltage. Thus, a rising curve is obtained with forward bias as shown in figure. And from the forward characteristic, it is seen that at first the current increases very slowly and the curve is nonlinear. It is because the external applied voltage is using up in overcoming the potential barrier. However, once the external voltage exceeds the potential barrier voltage, the PN junction behaves like an ordinary conductor. Therefore, the current rises very sharply with increases in external voltage. And third is reverse bias. With reverse bias to the PN junction, potential barrier at the junction is increased. Therefore, the junction resistance becomes very high and practically no current flows through the circuit. A very small current flows in the circuit with reverse bias due to the minority carriers called reverse saturation current. And if reverse voltage is increased continuously, the kinetic energy of electrons may become very high, enough to knock out electrons from the semiconductor atoms. At this stage, breakdown of voltage occurs. What is breakdown and breakdown voltage? It is the minimum reverse voltage at which PN junction breakdown with sudden rise in reverse current. Okay, now time complete ho raha hai. And yes, semiconductor part hamara complete ho gaya hai. Next part hamara transistor, wo hum next lecture mein cover karenge. Okay friends, thank you. See you soon.
Okay.